It was predicted to be tight, but in the end it was resounding. New South Wales voting in a new Labor era, emphatically rejecting the coalition after 12 years in power. This is the state of play tonight. As you can see from the predicted makeup of state parliament's lower house, Labor has secured the most seats. But as more results came in late last night, it began to fall short of the 47 needed for a majority. 11 seats are simply too close to call right now. So we'll have to wait and see if Labor governs in its own right, with a minority government still possible. Regardless, New South Wales has a new premier-elect, and Chris Minns has promised to get straight to work.
Morning, everybody. Morning. How are you doing? Nice to see you all.
Christopher John Minns, dad of three, flat white drinker.
Oh, thank you.
And 47th Premier of New South Wales, a title that'll take some getting used to.
It's going to take a while. Yeah, when you said it, I sort of looked around to see who else was there. I am conscious that it's an awesome responsibility and today looks different to yesterday.
A difference delivered through a history-making victory. 12 years in opposition ending as the party retook seats lost in the 2011 bloodbath, like Riverston.
For the very first time in a very, very long time, River now belongs to Labor.
And East Hills.
I can sleep in tomorrow, but I don't think I will. I think I'll party all night.
Certainly from our perspective, this is a victory. As a famous Labor person put it, for the true believers, it's also a real humbling experience.
Sealed with a kiss.
I'm excited!
The Brighton Lesands function room enraptures. As mainland Australia went wall-to-wall red.
For my friend, the Premier of New South Wales, Chris Minns. Thought it was going to be close, but in the end we got there. Thanks, everyone.
Labor's path to power ran through Western Sydney, flipping the seats of East Hills, Camden, Penrith, Riverston and Parramatta. Ryde is still in doubt, but Labor is ahead in the count. The party also flipped the regional seats of Monaro and South Coast and is ahead in Terrigal, which remains too close to call. With those 9 seats, the ALP would have the 47 required for majority government. Minns easily holding on to his own seat of Kogra.
And I'm proud to say today the people of New South Wales voted for the removal of the unfair wages cap in New South Wales.
And we made sure that we focus on things that matter to people. Education, health, wages, the cost of living, the tolls. That's what was really important, and that's what we had to stay true to.
We have a change of government, great news. The fact of the matter is we need outcomes for the people who got us through the pandemic.
A job that starts today, the leadership group meeting this afternoon.
Ensuring that we've got our plans in place, particularly for essential workers, particularly for essential services in New South Wales, is an urgent priority.
The first piece of legislation, protecting Sydney Water from privatisation by putting it in the Constitution, while the Premier-elect says he will reach out to the man he's replacing.
I do hope to catch up with Premier Perrottet in the coming days, and I think he held himself very well in this election campaign, and despite the fact that he lost and we won, I don't think this political campaign diminished him at all.
A fresh start for the state and the Minns family, where Sunday breakfast will never be the same again. Lachlan Kennedy for 10 News First.